So it's Christmas time, and we're going to have the new year period, and we're, people are going to be overeating. We're here with Natalie Golland from OTT Training based in Brighton. You're a personal trainer, Natalie, and we're going to go through like some of the do's and don'ts over eating, but also how we might, you know, simple ways of trying to keep fit over the festive period. Maybe start off with the overeating. I know you're an expert really on you know, what the do's and don'ts, you know, over, particularly when there's calorific foods, plenty, you know, to go around, isn't it?
Yes, so Christmas is obviously a really difficult time because we do all love to overeat, and all the food around Christmas is fatty and sugary and salty. So one of the main things that you can do is drink lots of water. Plan the days that are maybe going to be a little bit worse than others. So i.e. Christmas Day is going to be a very naughty day, isn't it? And you're going to eat your roast dinner, your chocolates, your big breakfasts, but plan ahead so you can make the days before a little bit lighter.
Yeah.
And the days after maybe a little bit lighter. And also exercise can counterbalance that. So if you know you're going to have a bad day on Christmas Day, you could go out and go for a little light run or a walk, or do a little bit of a session before to help out a little bit.
Exactly. So, I mean, when do we get the box of the tin of Quality Street out then? Just on Christmas Day, is that what you're saying?
No. Yeah. So maybe, like I was saying, plan it. So get that box out. But sit and think when you can have a little bit, and don't have the whole box.
Because this is where we all go wrong. It's the sweets, isn't it? When you've got a big tin there, just sitting there, you're watching The Crown or whatever on Netflix, it's just easy to
kind of keep going.
Just to keep going.
I know, but give yourself a certain amount.
Yeah.
You know, have a look at the nutritional value on the back. Work out what one portion is.
With a toffee in you.
And then put that portion in front of you and enjoy it.
Yeah.
Don't kind of sit and eat the whole entire box, because you end up eating and not enjoying what you're eating.
You're just doing it for the sake
of it. Just doing the sake of it, because it's there.
Yeah. What about kind of like food portions? I mean, if people always want extra Christmas pud or extra, you know, Yorkshire puddings, whatever. I mean, that's where it can all get wrong. Or just have extra sprouts, if you're a big fan of sprouts,
or extra carrots.
If you're, do you know what I mean? I mean, there is, or should we just let our hair down on Christmas Day and just forget about it?
I think you have to let your hair down. Everyone has to let their hair down, but it's being mindful. So if you're going to have your massive big Christmas dinner and you want to have pudding and then you want to have your after eights after, just bear in mind that morning you could go for a walk, you're going to go for a light jog, you're going to do some exercise, your breakfast is going to be maybe a little bit smaller, and then your lunch is going to be lovely and light, and then you've got that room to have your roast dinner.
Yeah.
And obviously don't cram it all in, you know.
Yeah.
When you are full, try and stop.
Exactly, that's good advice. What about getting fit then? And I guess a lot of your clients are going to be coming back with a few extra pounds, are they? Or is that where you're...
Well, hopefully not. You don't have to put weight on over Christmas.
Yeah.
I think the main thing you need to do is plan, you know, plan walks and events that are moving more than maybe you would normally do. So you could plan to go and meet some friends for a nice walk, or you could plan to meet some friends on the beach and do a little gym session, or family, do a little session at home with your family, and you set those dates in your diary for the Christmas period.
Yeah.
So that you can know that on those days you're going to be exercising or moving more.
Yeah, and I know you're going to be showing us some exercises that people could do at home, but I mean, going for a walk around a block's better than nothing, isn't it?
Definitely. You
know? I mean, that's...
And I hear this a lot with lots of clients. Oh, I only have 10, 15 minutes to train. Brilliant. Spend 10, 15 minutes training.
Yeah.
It's 100 times better than not doing anything.
Yeah, and don't knock training as well as... And don't knock walking, I should say. And definitely don't knock training. I mean, walking's fine, isn't it? It's still a good thing. It's
brilliant.
Cardiovascular, you know, gets the pulse racing a bit, particularly if it's a fast walk. It does.
Yeah.
It is okay, isn't it?
Walking's absolutely brilliant. If you want to kind of get your heart rate up a little bit more, you know, plan your walks with a hill.
Yeah.
So you can walk up hills, you can go a little bit faster, go for a walk along the beach with the wind in your face, that's harder.
Yeah.
Just kind of long walks as well, you know, you could go out for an hour and a half with your family and friends.
Yeah. So what about January then, Natalie? If people have overindulged, you know, if they have put their hand in a Quality Street tin too many times, what can people do in January? What's the tips?
So straight in January, you need a nice, fresh kind of mindset. You draw a line and go, as of now, we're back onto moving more, eating healthier, picking up better choices, and maybe all those leftovers that you might have, maybe put them in a box.
Yeah.
And kind of forget about them for a few weeks.
You can send a bin, but yeah, put them in a box. Yeah.
Well, it'd be wasteful to pop them in the bin, wouldn't it? You know, you can still eat those things, but just spread them out. Yeah.
Spread out the love.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
One quality street a day.
Exactly. And of course, you know, January, new year, new start. So a lot of people, that's when a lot of people get into exercise, actually, isn't it?
Definitely.
It's just that some people don't carry it on for the rest of the year. That's the unfortunate thing.
Well, I think the most important thing about exercise and fitness is that you make it part of your lifestyle and you find something that you enjoy and you carry it on the whole time. So it is part of your life. You know, you do it, you know, once a week, twice a week, whatever works for you.
Yeah.
But you need to hold on to it and stay motivated. And that's the most important thing.
So how can people find out about OTT training then? Because I know you're doing particularly Zoom, a lot of Zoom stuff, aren't you? Which does work, doesn't it? I know we spoke about it during lockdown, didn't we? And
Zoom's brilliant.
Yeah.
I think Zoom works a lot more efficiently than I expected.
Yeah.
And especially over Christmas, we've got classes running.
Yeah.
And they'll be pretty much on times and days that you're available. So they're not going to be on Christmas Eve, even though lots of you like to train on Christmas Eve. So you can find me on my website, which is OTT Training.
Yeah. Okay, thanks for coming in today, Natalie. People can see you on OTT Training, and I know you're regularly on the latest TV as well. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you
for having
me. Happy
Christmas. Have a good new year. Cheers.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Natty from OTT Training, and I'm here today to show you a little workout. I thought I'd show you a little sofa workout to you do over the Christmas period. You can do it once you come back from a run or a walk, and it doesn't take very long. You don't need very long to do a little session, just 5 to 10 minutes. So the first exercise we're going to start is we're going to do squats. So grab yourself a sofa or a chair, and all you're going to do is make sure those legs are shoulder width apart, and you're literally going to squat and down and tap your bum on the chair like so. So numbers, you can pick how many you think is good for you. So today I'm going to do roughly about 10 to 15, but you can pick 5, or you can even pick up to 20, as many as you feel is good for you. So I'm going to go for another 5. Well done, another 4, 3, good, 2, keep those eyes up nice and high, and last one from there. I'm going to take them onto sofa pulses. So I'm literally just going to pulse down, and I'm going to bounce like so for 15. Make sure these knees don't pop over your toes, and your hips are pushing back. So I'm going to go for another 10. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. From there, I'm then going to sit down, and I'm going to do a little bit of abs. So you just lean slightly back. You can place your hands on your sofa wherever you can. You've got 2 options, single legs, so just bringing one leg up at a time, or double legs, tucking both knees into the chest, like so. And again, I'm going to stick to my 15, so I'm going to do another 10. Good. But you can stick to the numbers that feel good for you. Well done. Make sure you breathe out as you bring those knees to your chest. So I'm going to go for another 3, 2, and then final one. I'm then going to hold it up high like so. So if you're doing single leg, you can keep one leg up and hold. And again, I'm just counting for 15 seconds. I've got another 4, 3, 2, and 1. Perfect. So you've just done squats, squat pulses, double leg or single leg raise for your abs, and then the hold. And now we're going to move on to arms, and I'm going to do tricep dips, keeping my back nice and tight to the bench or the sofa or whatever you're using. I'm going to push my elbows all the way back and come down to a 90 degree angle. Brilliant. So if you want to make the exercise harder, you lengthen the legs away from you. If you want to make it easier, you bring them closer to whatever you're using. So we're going to go for another 4, 3, 2, and final 1. Lovely. So take a little rest for a second, and then we're going to do that little hold again, 15 second hold. So we're going to go down, and we're going to hold for 15, or whatever number you picked. Good. So I've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, and final 1. Lovely. ease off of that. So we're going to do one more exercise. And that is going to be a little plank. So you can literally pop your hands on your sofa, extend like so, and hold. If you want to make it a little harder, you can bring one knee in, take it out, other knee in, take it out. And again, do that number that you selected, so 15 or 5 or 10. And just gently keep those going, remembering to breathe. And again, we're going to go for another 4, 3, 2, and final one. There you go, you are done. So that's a few exercises that you can do when you come back from your walk or your run. You can do them a few times. So you could do them 3 times or 4 times. Or you can even time them. So you could do 30 seconds of each of those exercises and do it 2 or 3 times. Enjoy.